department all manage its employees and rotate the company around 24/7, catching some funny, awkward, and sometimes inappropriate things on camera. In this episode, we're taking a closer look at the organizational structure and the day-to-day activity in Scranton. Before this episode airs, let's get you up to date on some characters and what business management concepts are going to be implemented to resolve the issue.
Michael Scott. He is the regional manager of Dunder Mifflin Incorporated, located in Scranton, Pennsylvania. He is a single, middle-aged man. Michael spends the majority of his time distracting others and procrastinating. He is known for making inappropriate and awkward statements to individuals. Michael commonly shows a lack of empathy. He is unwilling to recognize or identify with others' feelings. He makes decisions based on what is best for the company. His laid-back approach results in lower-than-expected workplace productivity. Michael places his personal interests as a priority over work. Some examples of this include his birthday, someone else's birthday, or the various seminars. Michael has hard work ethic, cares about employees, and wants a fun work environment, but does show some immaturity in many instances, including thinking he can simply declare bankruptcy and have it take effect. Michael has narcissistic traits and behaviors. Jim Halpert. He is the salesman at Dunder Mifflin Incorporated. He rarely bothers to fulfill his full potential and insists that his job as a salesman is just a job and not a career, despite the many years he has spent there. He is known for being the tall and handsome guy in the office. He ends up having a relationship with Pam Beasley, the receptionist. He is considered the hero of the show. Jim has a laid-back and happy-go-lucky attitude. He is an underachiever with a passion for pranks. Jim loves playing pranks on his coworker and deskmate, Dwight Schrute. An example is Jim convinces Dwight that he is Asian by bringing an Asian into the office to take his place. Jim has good communication skills, likes getting along with other people, and especially enjoys having fun in the office. Pam Beasley. She is the secretary of Dunder Mifflin Incorporated. Pam has grown the most throughout the office. She starts out being portrayed as reserved, lacking both self-confidence and courage to make real changes in her life. She ends up being courageous, funny, and confident. Compared to the others in the show, she is the most normal. It is important to her that she keeps Michael focused on his work. He respects her opinion. She likes being productive and making sure others are too, but sometimes she does help Jim and some of his friends. Jim and Pam start dating and eventually start a family. Pam has a good understanding for the budgets and cost constraints for the company. She is essentially both the secretary and treasurer. Dwight Schrute. He is the top salesman at Dunder Mifflin Incorporated and is the assistant to Michael Scott. Dwight lacks social skills and common sense. He is very gullible and oftentimes finds himself to be the center of the office pranks. Despite his dislike of Jim because of his pranks, the two together are a very effective team. He always overdresses for work, considers himself greater than his coworkers. He has also shown expert levels of knowledge and training in hospitality management, seduction, social dynamics, agriculture, espionage, and economics. Stanley Hudson. Stanley is a sales representative. He is a serious, hard worker, but is very dissatisfied with his job. Stanley, who is Black, is constantly subjected to Michael's inadvertently offensive remarks based on racial stereotypes. At times, Stanley plays along with Michael's comments for his own benefit. Michael refers to Stanley as Stanley the Manly. Stanley is so grumpy most of the time that he doesn't even notice all the pranks going on around him. Stanley does not like and is very disrespectful to his boss, Michael Scott. He is openly critical of him. Michael Michael Scott explains Stanley's remarks as clever and sassy. Phyllis Vance. She is a sales representative for Dunder Mifflin Incorporated. She is married to Bob Vance. She is quiet but loves to girl talk and gossip. Even though she has a sweet, motherly exterior, she can sometimes be very vindictive. Phyllis serves on the park planning committee, where she often butts heads with hypocritical Angela Martin, who Phyllis does not like at all. She went to school with Michael Scott and oftentimes insulted and embarrassed by his comments. She was also apparently very promiscuous in high school, which resulted in her unplanned pregnancy. Janet Levinson. She is the vice president of Northeast Sales at the paper distribution company Dunder Mifflin Incorporated, directly supervising Michael Scott. Her office is based out of New York, so most of her communication with the Scranton, Pennsylvania office is done over the phone. She has a very tight management style in comparison to Michael Scott's laid-back approach. Michael and Janet's personalities contrast to much humor in the show, particularly in their professional attitudes and social interactions. In very stressful situations, Janet will smoke cigarettes.
Now it's time for this week's episode. In this episode, Michael Scott leaves Scranton to go on a work meeting in which he's in charge of finding a replacement for himself. In this episode, we're going to go over some of the organizational concepts where Michael has to implement management strategies and fixing the organizational structure of the office, since he's no longer going to be in town. Stay tuned, and I hope you enjoy. In this week's episode, Michael Scott pulls Jim and Dwight aside into his office, where he announces to them that he will be leaving the office for a week. So, naturally, he needs someone to take charge of the office and make sure everyone is performing at peak performance the whole time while he's gone and not messing around. So, Jim, having tenure over Dwight and also being the number one salesman, while Dwight, being the assistant to the assistant regional manager of Scranton, are both viable options for the position. But Michael Scott does end up choosing Jim over Dwight, which Dwight is a little less than happy about. Dwight originally does accept the decision and respects Michael's decision, but on the way out, you can see that he grumbles a few words under his mouth and just walks out of the